Welcome to Genshin Impact, and thank you so much for joining me. Finally, we have got housing in Genshin. Yay! It starts out with you doing a quest called a Teapot to call home. It's not a difficult quest, and we will meet a new character in the game. And at the end of the quest, we will get the reward Serenity Pot, which Granny is giving us. Some of us have done other quests inside of her teapot, and this is a gift she wants to give us. So when you have got the pot, the next quest, A Teapot to Call Home Part 2, begins. The fun begins. So let's enter the teapot and see what's happening. We get a choice between three different realms. Can make a little preview so you can see what they are. There's Cool Isle, which I'm very excited about since I love water. And there's Emerald Peak, for those who want to live up in the mountains. And for those who want to live up in the sky, there's a floating abode. And I have chosen the Cool Isle. So let's get there and see how it looks like.
Wow! This teapot seems even bigger inside than Madam Ping's! There's even a great big house in the middle too! Nothing around it.
Yeah, it's much bigger than you think. Get chiseling, Paimon. You could carve us a whole house out of this rock.
That? Well, you're the one with the sword anyway. You do it. Still, why is it so empty here apart from that house? Oh, wait a second. What is that?
Yeah, what is that? But let's run around a little first before we go to the house and check out the area. A little disappointment is, though, as you could see, there are borders. I thought we could really be down on the beach. But maybe it will get unlocked later on, I don't know. Otherwise, it's a lot of area to be putting down buildings and other things I will show you shortly. Yeah, I'm at the red border again. Because here you can see it's a little bridge. And I actually thought that, oh, but maybe we can cross that, but no. Not yet, anyhow. So let's get around the house and see who this is.
Well, it seems that we have a visitor.
It's a huge finch!
Excuse me, I am not a finch. I am a teapot spirit, and you may call me... hang on a moment. What am I supposed to be called again? Oh, call me... I suppose you may call me... Tubby.
You certainly look the part. Oh, that wasn't nice.
So you're the little helper Madam Ping mentioned?
Madam Ping? Oh, you must mean Ping. Yes, she did summon me here. She told me much about you. You may leave all matters regarding the upkeep of this realm to me. Your journey may be far from over, but at least this way you will not want for a comfortable place to sleep each night.
So what's a teapot spirit exactly?
Though it is the Adepti who create realms such as this, they generally do not have the time of day to attend to the banal matter of their maintenance. Thus, we teapot spirits were created to help guard their realms and manage their affairs. You may consider me a butler, if you will. Now, allow me to explain this realm to you. Have you any blueprints on you? Specifically, blueprints with beautiful rooms, chairs, and the like. As long as you have a blueprint, you can refashion this realm however you please.
Blueprints? Oh, that's right! Granny handed us some when she gave us the teapot, didn't she? Let's take them out and have a look.
Yes, these are the blueprints I'm talking about. Go on, open them up. Just commit the image of the objects to memory and prepare the necessary materials. Then simply release the thought from your mind and the object in the blueprint shall appear within this teapot.
Wow! Is that all it takes? Then we could build a whole city inside, couldn't we?
I doubt it. A golden-eyed Adeptus explained this to me at some point in the past. He said that even though subspace creation is a product of Adeptal power, even that has its limits. This world is not a true one, after all. It provides merely a moment of brief respite from the mortal realm, not a means of escaping it entirely.
A golden-eyed Adeptus? Paimon wonders who could that be?
I hardly remember myself. What's more, since.
How very strange.
Well, let's not dwell on that. Have a look around. Best you get accustomed to this realm. If there's anything you would like to ask, just look for me.
And here we get a little tutorial of all the different things about this Serenity pot. And I can't read all this. I hope you can see what it says on the screen. Otherwise you will see it, of course, when you do this quest yourself.
Onwards, we have work to do.
Typical Jean, always so stressful. Showing here also what they call creation screen. It's what I would call crafting, but I call it creation. And here you can see we can gather wood in the game. I discovered it before I did this quest, actually, by coincidence. And as you can see, we will be able to get all kinds of different furnishing, houses, buildings, and it's going to be other things that I will show a little later in the video. Like
it's
trees
time to move
and so on.
We shouldn't stay here.
We should stay here, Jean. Calm down, calm down. There's a lot of new things and menus, but I think this is really fun that they have implemented housing in this game. The next, I hope, will be some sort of farming. If it isn't in this, I don't know. I haven't seen it yet. So let's go get inside, I mean, of this big house. This is going to be so fun to decorate. In here, maybe I'm gonna make a kitchen. I don't know. It looks a little like a kitchen. And in here, maybe I don't know if it's going to be an office or something, maybe a bedroom here, something. So there are three rooms downstairs, and then when we head up here, there are two doors, I think it is. We can't enter the door right now, but who knows, maybe we will unlock them later, because I don't understand why they would make a two storage house if we can't use it. Yeah, two doors. So it's quite big. The other buildings that we can place, I don't know if we can enter them. That will be fun to discover later on.
Maybe you're...
And here we can see the different things that we will unlock. There is special currency in this teapot. So we can unlock different things. And here we will see, yeah, different things we can put on the outside of the house. There are many different trees, bushes. Different colors. Different rocks. Boulders, maybe it's called. So, what I don't know, because I haven't tried it yet, is if we place one of these items, if we can pick them up, if we regret to place them. I mean, we maybe place them in the wrong area. That I don't know. I hope we can, because it's going to be hard when it's so big to know at first how will I decorate this and so on. But you see, there are a lot of different trees that we can plant outside, and It's going to be fun to see what other people, how they are decorating their spaces. And at the end you saw that... I want to call it a geo-rock, I can't remember what it's called, but... here you see different furnitures, which also are a lot. So we will gather resources and get blueprints, and then we can craft. So, and here we can see rooms and flooring and so on. So I'm wondering if it is that we can unlock those two locked doors to put in, so that, it will be two rooms. We will see, we will see. So there's a lot to choose between. You see, there are some flowers also to have indoors, flower pots. And here we have a little of, you saw there was houses and, oh, there's so many things, so I don't know where to start. A scarecrow, that's why I'm hoping for a little farm. I guess in a way that maybe I put in everything that we have seen in the game, because that would have been easier for them. But maybe there are also some new things. Maybe they will also add other things.
Maybe you're not used to the place at the moment, but once you've materialized enough rooms and furniture through subspace creation, it will feel just like home.
She says that every time when you talk to her. And here we are in the creation menu. I want to call it crafting. And we can also make three different dyes. And as you can see, the resources is three different things. So we can choose any we want. So it's good it's not just one particular resource. I have so many resources because I'm collecting like crazy. And here I will craft a stove, a stone stove. And the crafting time is really long. You can see it's 16 hours. But then they have this potion speed up time that I will use to make this, because 16 hours is a long time. Speed creation up. I don't know how we get this, but wait, I saw that in the menu we saw earlier. So we can exchange to get more of these. So I use one of these, so the stove is ready. And can start crafting this house, which will take 14 hours. But as I said, I don't know if we can enter these other buildings that we are going to place. And this is how it looks in the decoration menu. I call it decoration menu. And this is the stone stove that I have just crafted. So you can zoom in and you can turn the object around. And this, by the way, makes me think that we actually can cook in our house. That would be good for us who are cooking and making different dishes and so on. But I hope we can pick it up if we place it wrong. Because it's really hard to know where to place things when you don't have an idea. And here I had a table also. So the more that we are getting blueprints, we can craft more furnitures and decorate the fun part. Here you see there can be a full set of furniture we can place. I'm missing the chairs there. And they
Osmanthus
also have...
wine tastes the same as I remember.
Oh.
But where are those who share the memory?
Yeah, he always talk. Every one of them, I actually always talk. And this is like, they call it Adeptal Mirror. Where we also unlock items that we can decorate with. So now we have another book with quests. There's a lot of things in this game. But I think this is a very fun thing that they have implemented. So you can see here there are different furnitures.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember.
Yeah, you have said that.
But where are those who share the memory?
Oh, he's so deep. But he is a god also. Or he have you stepped down to be a god. But still. Just going through everything. For those who are curious to see what we can get. It's a lot to read. So I hope you don't mind that I'm not reading. My eyesight is so poorly, so I have a little difficult to sit and read.
Osmanthus wine tastes the same as I remember.
A third time? Man, Xiongli.
But where are those who share the memory?
Go and drink your wine. And there's also a trust rank that we will build up with this. What was the bird called? Can't remember it now. Which also make us get nice rewards. And I have got the items. I don't know what it was to get the first rank up. So I will unlock it. I will get 60 Primo Gems. Oh, but there is the... In the middle, I think it is that... what was it called? Speed up time potion. No? Jo, speed. It must be that. Okay, so we get it from leveling up here. And then also a house. A blueprint. We have to gather the resources. So, it's a lot of things. More to do in this game. Thank you. It seems like we get primer gems for each rank. I hope so. And more of this speed up time. And then there is this currency that I now clicked on. Not sure how we get those, but realm currency. And this bare bones, adeptile energy, and so on. This, I'm not sure how it works. There's a lot of things to take in like this. And here it says that increase your trust rank to unlock another one if you want to switch. Yay! We're so happy, aren't we? Yeah, we're really happy. Here's the map. If it is that we actually can unlock all three realms and then swift between them as we like, or if it is just that we, let's say I want to go from this place, I don't want to have this, I want to live in the sky
boats
instead.
Boats are made for transferring commodities back and forth.
Zhongli.
And those that come across Lior tend to stay a while.
And here we can see
so
that
it is where many things come to settle.
It's interfering with me. That you, how you leave the pot. So then you can get the world map up and then click on where you want to go. So we can open up this pot wherever we are on the world map and get to our own little realm, our peaceful little realm, and decorate or do whatever. And as...
Where do you want to go next? If you'd like to see Liyue's.
As I understood it, we can actually have friends to come over to our realms, and we can visit them, and we can help each other out with something, if there is the resources or unlocking something. So that is fun. Thank you so very much for watching, and I hope you're as excited and happy as I am over the housing in Genshin. Take care, and I hope to see you soon again. Bye!